Good morning. This is a special day of music celebration. The sacramental part of our worship today will be the New Testament Christmas lessons, and we will respond with prayer, praise, and thanksgiving, especially with the Christmas hymns today. So you always judge the message of a church. If you were dying, the message that you heard today, would that be one you would be thinking about as you were ready to take those last breaths? And so today we're going to hear certainly that type of a message as we hear about the nativity of our Lord, the incarnation, where God decided to come down and be one of us. Martin Staub has put a lot of work in this, and you're going to hear your choir, who maybe you haven't heard for a while, but been recorded in previous times. And, of course, the team that we are so favored with, Amanda Staub and Sam Keeler, they'll sing O Holy Night, which Marty arranged for them. And if I forget, at the end, Marty has a special announcement for you about a Christmas Joy CD. So let's prepare our hearts and our minds for worship. As we light our candles this morning, we will be on our Advent 3 Sunday. Our liturgist can come forward and light the candles now. And that the third candle is the pink candle, the Gaudete candle. You remember the Latin word for that? It means what? Joy. And so if you follow our teachers here at the school, especially our second grade teacher, they describe joy this way. It starts with Jesus, then it flows to others before it comes to you. So may this Christmas and Advent season be one of joy. We light our candles. Then we will make our beginning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Unto us a child is born. The child is Christ our Lord and God. The child is born for you. Let us come together today to worship and adore him. Come, thou long-expected Jesus. Our first reading is from Isaiah 9, verses 2 through 7. Darkness to light is the hallmark of creation. Divine creation means eternal peace. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them the light has shined. You've multiplied the nation. You've increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish it and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of the hosts will do this. God is the ultimate program manager. He plans the work and works the plan. In this prophecy, God works. Isaiah chapter 40, verses 3 through 5. A voice cries out in the wilderness, "Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." Every valley shall be lifted up, every mountain and hill made low, the uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Prophesy or prophecy means to declare the word of God. And so Micah chapter 5 verses 2 through 4 prophesies. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth.
Come now.
Luke's Christmas gospel, he carefully presents divine events. He sits them alongside historical people and places and genealogy. Luke chapter 2, the first 7 verses. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration. It was taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for him in the inn. Since the very beginning, God has used signs to connect us with faith. Flaming angel in the Garden of Eden. Pain in childbirth for women. Toil and sweat in work. For the cut covenant of Abraham and for the staff of Moses. And even now, water in baptism, bread and wine in Holy Communion. But the greatest sign is a child lying in a manger. Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 12. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You'll find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
Mary, did you know?
Well, that first Christmas, our peace offering with God came down to us. Luke chapter 2, verses 13 and 14. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." Those who hear the gospel and put their faith in action find that the gospel is contagious. It must be shared. Luke chapter 2, verses 15 through 20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what they had been told about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying, praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them.
Glory to God on high.
Wisdom responds to Jesus with obedience, with worship, with the tithe, with ministry. Jesus came not only for the Jew, but also the Gentile, you and me. The reading is from Matthew 2, the first 11 verses. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying, "Where is the child who was born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
At the first creation, Genesis tells us, God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and water were on the earth. God said that Friday, the sixth day, was good. He rested on the seventh day. At Christmas, Jesus starts a new beginning. He again is the agent of creation. God again finds the Friday of his passion good. We call it Good Friday. Jesus rests in the tomb on the seventh day. And the eighth day begins the new beginning of resurrection and peace now, not only on earth, but in heaven. Our reading is from John 1, the first five verses. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
Oh,
dear friends, we are grateful for your love and compassion ministry here at Grace Lutheran Church. Faith, tithing, and finances are inseparable. True joy is not found in storing things and an increasing inventory that requires bigger barns. True joy starts with clinging to Christ, who poured out his life's blood for us on the cross. So may God bless you, and may your tithing ministry be a blessing. Your tithes and offerings can be made here via our website and our online giving form. Your donations can also be mailed to Grace Lutheran Church, 1200 Charles Street, La Plata, Maryland. We ask you to use our online fellowship folders to let us know you're worshiping with us and to submit your prayer requests. Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus for this third Sunday in Advent and for all people according to their needs. Show us your steadfast love, O Lord. Grant us your salvation. Keep your saints from every folly, that would turn them from your words of peace. Lord, in your mercy, you sent John the baptizer to proclaim the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Richly and daily forgive our sins and the sins of all believers. Gather and preserve your holy Christian church by your voice, and send us faithful preachers who will not deny but confess your truth. Lord, in your mercy. Dear Father, be the strength, the source of all strength and comfort in every home. Bless the children of our families, that every darkness would be lightened by your Son's gracious visitation. Sanctify them completely, that their whole spirit, soul, and body may be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy. Give wisdom and success to our nation, its leaders, and all people. Protect all who serve in harm's way. Lord, in your mercy. Receive our thanks in every circumstance for your kindness in Christ Jesus and the certain hope of the resurrection of eternal life with him. We pray especially for those in any need at this time or who we wish to name before your altar. Lord, in your mercy, give us faith to believe the New Testament in your blood, to seek your Holy Supper for the forgiveness of sins, and to confess your truth with honest hearts in communion with one another. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, Father, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus came in his incarnation at that first Christmas. He comes to us even to this day in word and sacrament, and he is coming again. And so we read again the prophet Isaiah chapter 60. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of our dawn. God bless Marty. I think our minister of music's preached a pretty good sermon so far, don't you? Give him some applause. Marty, if you hear me, are you ready for that announcement you wish to make? Well, it's got the CD for you for this worship service, and you can get it on your way out from John if you're ready for it. I hope this service has been a blessing to you. I hope it's prepared you for the Christmas season. Now you better prepared. You can cry with Jimmy Stewart and Donna Reed, right? We have the next Sunday in Advent coming up on Sunday, and follow that up with our Christmas Eve worship service. Look for all of that from Andy and our announcements and in our pages on the internet there. But again, we hope you're back with us this Wednesday and this coming Sunday, and also just look at our social media pages for all the things that will be going on from Christmas Eve through the first of the year. Receive the special Christmas benediction. May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the eagerness to proclaim the gospel of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child, the offering, peace offering from God. And so may Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and may the Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen.